Okay, today we are going to do the functional test of our LCP panel, lighting contactor panel with 24 volt DC, two wire, so right over here. But before we proceed, we're going to identify our materials which is installed inside the panel. So here, we're going to incorporate our bill of materials and our schematic diagram for the lighting panel. So right over here, we're going to check physically what are the materials installed inside the panel based on our bill of materials. So for example, as what you see here, the main breaker, you will find it's TED124100 is you can find in this area. All right, and then we have also the contactor. Okay, and contactor also you will find from there mark with C1, and also you will find in the contactor identification plate, you will find C1 here, and we have the fuse link for the control. Okay, this is the fuse holder, and we have the fuse link inside, and this is 4 ampere. Okay, here, and we have also our terminal blocks, outgoing terminal blocks here, incoming terminal blocks, sorry. So here we have positive and negative. Okay, and this is our ground bus bar, and this is our outgoing TV for the controls. We disconnected already our photocell, so the photocell it's available here. Okay, so we will do the functional test, but first we are going to check the continuity test first. So here we go, we're going to proceed now the continuity test. So right over here, so positive to positive from terminal to breaker. Okay, and then we will check also the negative terminal to breaker. So you heard the beep, so that's it. Then now we are going to proceed now also the ground, continuity of the body to ground. Yes, and then next we will proceed also to Megger test. So now we are going to check the Megger test, insulation test for positive and negative to ground. So before we proceed that, we need to open our control fuse. So here we're going to open the control fuse, and now we're going to check the insulation test for positive and negative terminal. So all right, so right over here, positive and negative, that is the result, greater than 2200 mega ohms. And then now we're going to check positive to ground. Okay, so the same value, greater than 2200. Next, positive negative to ground. Okay, the same value also. So that is the result of our insulation test, Megger test. All right, so next thing to do, we are going to do high voltage test between positive and negative terminal, and also ground bus bar. Okay, so right over here, we are going to show to you our test kit. So this is our high voltage test kit available in this area. Okay, so we are going to inject 2200 kV for 60 seconds. So here we are going to use also our timer. Okay, so right now you will find that our positive and negative is already shorted, and the ground connection is also connected already through our high voltage kit. So right now we are going to inject 2.2 kV for 60 seconds. So here we go, 2.2 kV for 60 seconds. All right, this is our voltage control, and this is the output voltage. Okay, so we start here, our time start now. Please observe the output current. If we have any problem in our panel, So you will find an indication that there will be the movement in output current. So if the output current indication is stuck onto zero, means our panel is okay. So right here, this is high voltage, and our time right now is running. We need to finish up to the time cycle of 60 seconds, means 1 minute. Okay, 60 seconds. So that's it. Now we are going to do the functional test. All right, so now we are going to do a functional test. Our system voltage is 24 volt DC, as what you see in our schematic diagram. Okay. All right, and also you will find in panel itself 24 volt DC 2 wire, and our wire is already connected here. Okay. And going to positive and negative. So okay, we are going to show to you the incoming voltage, which we are going to check 24 volt DC. Okay, so that is the incoming voltage. All right, so now power supply available. We are going to switch on now our main breaker. Okay, this is connected through our contactor and our control fuse, and right over here. So once fuse closed, automatically we are in off status of the contactor. So once contactor on, automatically our indication lamp for on for contactor via manual, it will be on. So here, manual mode, we are going to switch on our contactor. So here, on. So once in manual mode, this is, you will find our selector seat position in manual position. So here, our contactor now is in close. Okay, close status means on. And also, I have to check our photocell. So the photocell is already connected and available here. So we are going to check the auto function of the photocell. So off and auto. So right now, going to check the photocell. So once the photocell sends the lux, means the brightness, automatically our contactor is off. So once we are going to put cover the sensor, automatically our contactor is on. So the photocell is covered, and here our contactor is on. So once the photocell sensor sends the lamp, automatically the contactor is going to open. So here we go. So that's the testing what we have. Thank you very much.